Foz Wardrobes again. Today I want to show you how to put a floor jam down so your floor track for your doors can go on. Okay, what we're going to need is the floor jam itself. And if you have a look at some of the tools, you'll need a masonry drill with a 5mm drill bit. You'll receive in your pack 3 or 4 masonry anchors. You'll need your 5mm drill in a standard drill. You'll need a hammer and a Phillips head driver, possibly. Okay, to fit your floor jam, slide it into one end and just lower it down between the wings of the wall jam. Now I'm going to drill through the floor jam and leave some dust on the carpet. Come in about 100 millimetres each end. Now depending on the pile on your carpet, will determine how many anchors you'll need to put in. This is quite a low pile tile, so we're only needing 3 anchors. If you had quite a high pile, you may need to go in between again with more anchors. But we'll ask you all those questions to determine what you're going to need. Now very carefully take off your floor jam, and you'll see 3 small piles of dust. You'll need a Stanley knife. We're just going to cut out a cube. Masonry drill. Just stand on it to keep your job secure. Make sure you go deep enough for the anchor. When your floor jam is securely in place, we can put our track on. Before I do, I want to show you the wheels that are at the back. Now, these wheels are special, they have an adjustment screw on them. So if I can get the camera to come down here. This is our adjustment screw here. So what we're going to do is put the top of the door into the back track and then lift the bottom over onto the back track on the bottom. Now if you come down the side here and have a look, you can see there's a gap up there and there's nothing down the bottom. We're touching nice and tight. So what we're going to do is tilt the door to suit the wall. And what I'm doing is pushing the door up like that. And I'm getting the screw, push the wheel down and turn the screw. And there we have it. If you're kit, you'll get some little dot that will cause the door to have a nice cushioned sound when it strikes on the end. Just put them up as high as you can reach and down near the bottom. Alright, we're going to do the same with the front door. In the top first. Bottom, slide it across, make any adjustments you need. For that professional finish, make sure you set the front door towards the entry of the room. That way it gives you a nice clean look.